Saturday to work.
I think that's great. That's, you know, do stuff like that for, you know, charity and stuff is always good. We do a lot of it, and, you know, I have no problem doing it. I love doing that kind of stuff. Help out when you can.
I think it's great. You know, our front office does a good job. Charlie Larson lines up a lot of good events for us. And anytime you can get in the community and, you know, give something back, you know, we're in the position to be able to do something like that. So I think it's, you know, it's really good.
It's great. I really always enjoy when we have some kind of team funds and things. It's a great thing.
I think we do a really good job for that. You know, I think next week we're going to Children's Hospital. Guys get around, we help out a lot of hockey practices with minor hockey. I think, you know, our front office does a really good job at organizing that, and I think the guys have a good time going to those, going to the practices or going to the hospital and just meeting people and getting our name out there, but also maybe helping kids.
Charity work. Good. I think, you know, it seems like a couple times a week we're, you know, going to, I don't know if it's charity, but we're going to schools and reading, and I know we got a hospital visit in a few weeks, and I know Harris, our owner, raises a lot of money for charities through different things that the players do, and I know our staff works really hard to raise money for all sorts of charities, so I think we do a pretty good job.
It's good. Great. We do a great job. You know, all the guys are always, you know, keen on doing it. There's not a time that I've heard a player say, "Oh, I can't stand that." There's, you know, what are we doing here? But no, we've done some great things in the community, and hopefully we keep on doing it. And you know, I know everyone appreciates it.
How do I feel about fighting in hockey?
I think there's good stuff and bad stuff about fighting.
Love it.
I think it's good. I think in like college hockey, you know, there's not much fighting, so you see a lot of like sticks getting up and guys getting hurt from high sticks and stuff like that.
I think it's important. I think, you know, some people don't feel should be in the game.
I think it's part of the game. You know, I'm a goalie, I don't really have to worry about it, but, you know.
I mean, it can get your team going and stuff like that, but overall, you know, there's not a huge need for it, I think. I mean, I don't fight.
I'm all for it. I think you need it just to help control, you know, the certain situations on the ice.
Here, you know, there's fighting, so guys are held accountable for sticking guys and stuff like that, so I think you see less sort of stick work in this league, because as soon as you stick a guy, you gotta pay the price.
Sometimes you need that guy to police some people who are maybe using their sticks a little bit too violently, or they're taking liberties on guys. And as long as you have a guy to police that, maybe that fighter, then maybe people won't, you know, take liberties on their star players. And I think it's important.
You can make it too important, like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just a whole part of game.
It's good. It's a good way to protect your teammates out there, protect your top players, and, you know, it's very entertaining for sure.
When dirtier players and stuff like that, you need to have guys take care of them, or, you know, to stick up for your teammates. And I think fans love it too. So,
you know, if it comes down to it, drop your gloves and kick the crap out of someone. It's the best thing.
I haven't seen a little bit long of time.
There's a lot. All the guys that are bigger than me.
What did I want? I'd take them all. I don't care.
There's plenty of those guys.
Probably that would be TJ Reynolds.
Probably have to go with Reynolds again on that one. Even though, you know, there's some other tough guys on our team, he's just a little bit crazy, and I don't think he can hurt him either. So.
Yeah, he's a pretty big guy. He's gives it to some guys and fights pretty good.
Probably TJ Reynolds. He's just got older, he's just crazy. And he's a good fighter, very good fighter, tough as nails. And, I see them just dummy some guys on the ice. And, I don't think I'd want to fight him too often.
Kelsey Wilson's really tough.
I wouldn't want to fight Kelsey Wilson. He's a tough bugger. I wouldn't want to fight Alex Henry. He's like one of the nicest guys in the world off the ice, but you just piss him off a little bit, he'll snap and he's a killer. This guy's a killer too. Nolan Jonkman. And he's 6'7", 260 pounds, so that's a little scary too.
Nolan Jonkman, big, huge, he's like 6'5".
Probably Nolan Jonkman. He's huge.
Best personal hockey moment?
Probably winning the Calder Cup my rookie year here in Milwaukee. It's pretty exciting. I came in as a 20-year-old punk and ended up winning a Calder Cup, so I was pretty happy about that.
My best personal moment was probably 2 years ago, juniors in Canada, where I played before I came here. In playoffs, we were down 3-0, and we came back and won 4 games straight in their arena to win the playoff series and go to the next round. So it was to be a part of something like that, it's pretty amazing in the hockey world.
Probably last year, we had a really good team here with the Admirals. We went to the Calder Cup Finals. Unfortunately, lost in 6 games, but we had a really close team, and it was a lot of fun making it that far and playing that far into June. It was really a lot of fun.
Probably just playing here. I guess signing an AHL contract. Up to this day, it's definitely just playing here.
It was probably in Finland. We won two championships in Finnish Elite League.
For me, it's probably just getting a chance to play in the NHL. It's probably the highlight. That's kind of everyone's goal who plays hockey.
My first game was October of 2005, 4 games into the season, unfortunately. It was a sad story. I replaced Kyle Schultz, a young man who died coming home after a game he played himself. And it turned into a bad situation, obviously, but they called me and I was able to fill in. And for me personally, things have worked out. It's about as good as it gets. First off, I'm covering hockey, which is fantastic. Second off, I'm dealing with a coaching staff that knows the game and knows how to teach the game and has patience to teach the game. And I'm dealing with a lot of players that are happy to be here. They love this building. They love this. They love this city. They love this organization. And the front office people are fantastic. So I got no problems. I mean, this is about as good as it gets. This is what I've always wanted to do, is to broadcast hockey on a professional level. So it's worked out. Do I feel the radio coverage expands the fan base? Yeah, I think it does. I think you're going to get your core audience. You're going to have people who love hockey, who, by and large, these kids aren't from here, so you have to sell the game. You can't necessarily sell individual players because at the AAA level, guys are going up and down, and you never know who's going to be here tomorrow. Well, they ran into that earlier this season with Alexander Radulov. You know, do you promote this guy? He's an incredible player, but he was only here for 10 games, so you really couldn't promote him. But the radio coverage, I think it does, and now we've tied it in with being on cable. So if people are scanning, and if they hear an excited voice, if they hear some passion, if they hear a nice crowd behind, I think they get interested, and I think they want to check out what's going on. Am I a big fan of the Admirals myself? Yeah, very much so, obviously. You turn into a situation, I was born and raised in Minnesota, or I was raised in Minnesota, I should say, and you become a fan of your home state, you know, big Twins fan, big North Stars, and all of that. But once you get to know people on a personal level, when I first moved here, I got to know Jeff Sauer at the University of Wisconsin when I moved to Madison. I instantly became a Badgers fan ahead of the Gophers because Jeff Sauer was such a good guy. And the same here, where I didn't necessarily know too much about the Admirals, before I got the job. I mean, I knew a little bit. I knew who they were. I knew some of the players and things like that. But now you see how great the hockey is. You see how good these guys are. I'm a huge fan. I have the best job in the fact that I get to watch hockey night in and night out, and then I get to have a relationship with these guys. And I'm not saying we're best friends or anything, but you get to see how these guys operate, how they work. You get to on the inside a little bit. It's pretty neat.